But this was a turning point because everybody understood corruption is not only about money, it's killing people. So it was for the first time that a whole country realized it could have been my children dying in the at this concert.
What did the fire at the Collective Club mean to Romania, and why did you choose to tell the story of this fraud into the Romanian healthcare system?
So the Collective Fire was a big turning point in the Romanian society because people realized that a popular club functioned without fire exits, without emergency exits, and that meant that it was authorized, most probably through corruption. And so it was a national trauma, and everybody thought, okay, now we have to stop with the corruption. You know, people accepted it. Corruption is accepted in Romania, as in many other societies. But this was a turning point because everybody understood corruption is not only about money, it's killing people. So it was for the first time that a whole country realized it could have been my children dying at this concert. And so we had this mix of generations in the streets for 2 weeks saying, like, we want to change our political class. The political elite is outdated, it has to go, it will kill us. And we were thinking about, you know, how could one capture in a film such a thing about society? Because it was something we felt will come and was starting to come in the whole of Eastern Europe. And then we thought, okay, the best place to start with would be the press. And Cătălin Tolontan, our main character, the investigative journalist, started to investigate on the role of the authorities in this catastrophe with the fire, and what happened then in the hospitals with the patients, because the Romanian government, with all the big doctors in the country, lied to the whole society that they can treat these patients, and it was a lie. They, knowing that they will die because of infections, they just lied that they can treat them. It was a bit like Chernobyl, you know, covering it up, knowing that people will die, but using the power of an authority to lie to a whole grieving population. And so we went to Cătălin Tolontan because he was the one digging into the role of authorities, and we thought that would be the best point to start to understand how society functions. How does the relationship between the citizens and the authorities and the press in the middle function? Why do we need the press, and what is the press capable of in informing the people and protecting their lives in front of populist governance?
When did you start working on the movie? In early 2016, I think.
Yes.
Did you figure out democracy would be that undermined, not only in Romania, but all over the world?
No, that was a big surprise for all of us, because we started the project, and along, as we went along, we felt like it's happening everywhere. So what we were just filming was just happening everywhere. I remember very well the morning I woke up, and my partner says, Brexit went through. It was a shock. It was really, I could barely get out of the bed. And we understood this is something that the story we are just telling is something that is not Romanian. It's something that's happening, it's a current that goes worldwide. And also the attack on the press happened after the election of Trump. You know, and so in a way, we told a story that was going to happen, you know, in many other countries.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thanks.